I'm going to discuss the big picture perspective of the Advanced Research Methods course. We will start out with the research problem and the research question. And there may be a number of questions to help answer a specific problem. Developing a problem will involve searching the literature, and there's a search process looking at our library database, Google Scholar, dissertation abstracts. There's a number of areas that will help you find a complete selection of articles in the problem that you're interested in and perhaps help focus you on specific research questions. During that process, you will also look at reasons why your specific area is relevant. Keep that in mind because you're going to be writing an introduction which is due on February 3rd. And the purpose of that is to develop a rationale for why this topic needs to be looked at. A big picture rationale and then also a research-based rationale if you're doing a thesis. If you're doing a project, you would look at the big picture only. Now, the next step will be looking at the literature in more depth, finding 30 articles at this stage, articles that are primary, articles that are secondary, and that will lead to the literature review assignment due on March 2nd. Now, you'll not only learn how to find the articles, but how to organize them. Organizing 50, 60, 70 articles is a massive endeavor, and it's very hard to keep the information straight. So we're essentially going to conduct a content analysis and develop an Excel database to help organize your literature review. And that will work really well for you, I guarantee. Well, as much as one can guarantee. And then we'll move into the methods section. And that will involve looking at different methods, qualitative and quantitative. Looking at data analysis and how we can actually find data that will help answer research questions that are relevant to us. And so you will do an overview of that methodology, both for the project and the thesis students, so that they will understand methodology, how to interpret papers and understand the results. But the final assignment will be different for the project and thesis students. Since the project students are doing a literature review, they will actually focus on developing their literature review in more depth. So that will be part two for them. Whereas the thesis students will develop a methodology to help answer the research questions that they're pursuing. Finally, we will develop a detailed plan for continuing on with the project or the thesis, which will involve the results section, the discussion section, and fully understanding the time commitment that is involved in completing these somewhat monumental tasks. At the end of the actual course, you will have a research proposal for either your project or your thesis, a well-developed research proposal, and you'll be able to use that as a guide to launch yourself into your project or your thesis.